Jess, up to 29 people were arrested out here after a clash with police earlier. These protesters seem to be doubling down on their commitment to stay out here in front of ISIS headquarters. Just take a look. I mean, there has to be at least double the number of people out here than earlier when things got crazy. A chaotic clash with police during day two of a protest outside the U.S. Customs and Immigration Office in Philadelphia.
They started moving in. They formed a line to start clearing, to move people out of that third garage door over there.
This organizer of the protest, Ann Lynn Wang, is among the dozen or so protesters and police officers caught up in this chaotic scene.
I was standing in the line locking arms with people. It is not a violent gesture in any sense whatsoever.
Protesters were blocking three garage doors outside ICE's headquarters here that allow ICE vehicles to transport arrested undocumented immigrants. This moment happened when Philadelphia police and Homeland Security officers demanded protesters move. Wang managed to escape this without being seriously hurt or arrested, but at least two people suffered scrapes and bruises. One was taken to the hospital for treatment, and 29 other protesters were cuffed and taken into custody.
But thankfully, we have legal support down here, and we're going to help get these people out as soon as possible.
In the middle of this clash, people were electronically donating money to help bail out those arrested. Others donated cold water and food to help remaining protesters double down and stand their ground. The protesters are still hoping that at least one of their demands are met. A demand to the mayor in Philadelphia to end a PARS agreement with ICE that allows the agency to access the city's resident database. It's being called by protesters as a reason ICE in Philly is one of the most active units in the country.
That agreement's up August 31st. Our law department, police department are studying that now, and we'll have some words on that closer to the end of the deadline.
The mayor there responding to protesters' demands, saying he is all for people protesting the treatment of undocumented immigrants at the border and here in the city, of course, saying those protests need to be peaceful. And right now, at this moment, that is what we are seeing. In Center City, Alicia Nieves, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.